Hello and welcome to your astrological vibrations for Monday, June 10th, 2019 by Gaia Blooming. There goes Mahalo. I was trying to record him instead of me. But that only worked for so long. He was on to me. So you get to look at my little view. Move it. And get some plants instead of Mahalo since he got down. Anyways, our energy mantra for June 10th is I am worthy of my highest consciousness. And we have an interesting connection going on today. We have the sun in conjunct Saturn. Anytime we have an in conjunct, it's really one of the most interesting aspects, I feel, because in oppositions, there are energies that are similar. Those energies, even if they are going to play tug of war, they know how to work together. In conjunct, they're not necessarily sure how to work together. So when we have the sun in Gemini, in conjunct Saturn, in Capricorn, we definitely have an interesting energy that we're working with. Sun in Gemini, our focus is the consciousness. And this is the consciousness of whatever, you know, whatever's coming into play. And in this regard, Saturn in Capricorn is hopefully lighting up for us that deepest purpose where we can connect into our soul purpose energy. However, Saturn in Capricorn really can connect us into conditioning energy. And that's where we often get very caught up in the Capricorn energy or even in the Saturn energy, is in the conditioning, in the shoulds, in those energies where we have kowtowed to society's demands. And so today we have an awareness of it, and it may feel a little uncomfortable. It may feel like that in conjunct, that energy of not seeing eye to eye, but we have the opportunity, the chance with this, within this energy, is to bring that sun's consciousness, that Gemini consciousness, and be like, I'm going to be conscious of the decisions I make. I'm going to be conscious of that distraction. There was a hummingbird that just flew outside. I'm going to be conscious of choosing joy. That's one of the messages of hummingbird. I'm going to be conscious of choosing my soul purpose path rather than falling into these pitfalls of the shoulds or showing up in my conditioning. And you know, conditioning, it's something we all have. It's something we all work through, but be very aware of that. And Gemini does want to stay generally on the light side of things, but Gemini may feel a little bit of the heaviness. And Gemini, as a mutable sign, can easily be swayed by the shoulds. So be very aware of your consciousness and don't be swayed by the outside shoulds. Be swayed by what it is you truly love and let that guide you. And I love this connection. It is happening at 19 degrees. That is 10 energy, and you are a 10. You are worthy of fully embracing your highest consciousness. You are worthy of fully embracing your soul purpose life, which will bring you joy, just like the hummingbird told us, showed us. Okay, so besides that, we have the moon finishing up in Virgo. So moon and Virgo can also add to that energy because moon and Virgo so longs on an emotional level to be of service. Now I often talk about moon and Virgo being on the healing level and moon and Virgo bringing up energy around the body, but that moon and Virgo can go hand in hand with that Capricorn energy, with that earth energy, and be like, this is what I should be doing. This is how I should be showing up. Especially as the moon in Virgo does connect to Pluto today. So be very aware. This is an opportunity for transforming how you are of service. I love that the moon in Virgo can also bring the energy of focus. Realigning your focus with purpose, realigning focus with joy, realigning focus with things that feel good, realigning your focus with the ability to say, I believe I can change. I'm worthy of these changes that are working me and working the world at this time. So you are worthy of this transformation. You have to take the action steps. You have to bring about your energy of authority with this, and empowerment. You know, that's part of that Pluto energy. We also have lots of 19 degree stuff today. We also have the sun opposite Jupiter today. And this is also really interesting. Jupiter is retrograde in Sagittarius. And so I said, with Jupiter retrograde in Sagittarius, we do have to go looking for the good. You know, the good may not necessarily show up as easily. Again, as this is 19 degrees, you are a 10. It's really important to be appreciative of yourself, even appreciative of how you are showing up in this energy, how you are showing up with this consciousness, how you're willing to maybe go past beliefs that you have carried into a new level of belief. So Sun opposite Jupiter, the good things are happening, the good things especially are happening within you, and really seriously, pat yourself on the back for going through all this. We have Moon, void of course, which means the energy can feel a little tired, the energy can feel a little wonky, and then it shifts into Libra, which is hopefully going to bring us about some balance. And we have some really interesting things that we're building into that are definitely going to serve by this balance. I think the major lesson of Libra that goes along with what we've been talking about, besides the worth stuff, which is definitely up and definitely part of the Libra stuff, but the other major message of Moon in Libra is that harmony lesson. Libra energy loves to have peace and harmony. Libra just wants everybody to get along, as does Gemini. And too often, these air signs are like, I will go with the wind and I will please everybody else to their own detriment. And then there hits a point where the Libra, the Gemini, or any other energies that do this are like, I can no longer go with the wind. I am the wind. So be very aware of where you may be falling into other people's patterns, other energies' patterns to maintain harmony and not honoring your own inner balance and your own inner harmony. Now, this is going to be very important. Like I said, we're building into an interesting energy. We're building into Mars conjunct the North Node this week, which means it is opposite the South Node, as well as Saturn and that Pluto energy. So we're going to have some of these oppositions. Mars represents our desires. And right now, Mars connecting, building into connection with the North Node is saying, you must nurture yourself. You must care for yourself. You must nurture your desires. You must nurture these energies that you are passionate about and not fall into those pitfalls of living up to the shoulds of the world, living up to the conditioning of the world, living up to somebody else's empowerment. So we're building into that. And so the Moon in Libra is giving us like a little advance on that. Find your balance by finding harmony within. Find your balance by listening to these things that are calling you. Listen to these energies of your heart. I keep trying to get this Rumi poem right, and I can't seem to get it. It will not lead you astray. It will not lead you astray, but you really have to believe it, and you have to believe in yourself. And sometimes we have to do a little clearing around our desires, because sometimes our desires can become wonky due to ego stuff or, you know, all kinds of other things. So sometimes we have to do a little check-in, a little clearing, but really be led by those things that silently pull at your heartstrings and your soul strings, because it's trying to get you somewhere on your path. And that's, I think, the biggest astro overhead. We're being called to get on our path. We're being called to nurture ourselves so that we can remember who we are and get back on our path. Final aspect of the evening is the Moon in Libra connecting to Venus in Gemini. Conscious conversations, conscious connections, so that you can remember those little pieces. I just see like various colors of a rainbow coming together and like reminding each other like, hey, I'm red and I enhance your orange, and I'm your orange and I enhance your yellow. You know, these little energies that come, oh, I have a sacred geometry thing right here. Oh, it's hard to see the colors and this lighting. But look at how they enhance. There we go. There's lighting. Look at how they enhance each other, these colors. They work together. And so having that conversation can help support that process. Anyways, I love the cards for today. Let's see. There we go. The Fool and slowing down. We are embarking on this new path that's part of this Mars energy on the North Node, but take it slow, minute by minute. It's also pay attention in this moment to what is going on, that totality. Be here now. Be here now. So important. I also have the letting go and the miser. And I think this goes with the conditioning energy. Let go of what you've been conditioned or where you've been conditioned that doesn't honor your soul. Let go of where you've been conditioned that doesn't honor that passion and that path that is with you. And again, baby steps. You don't have to do it all at once, but it is happening. So do be aware that it is happening. So that is it for today. Sorry that Mahalo did not decide to stay, but it was nice that you got a little glimpse of him sitting in the window, gazing out at all of the things that he would like to catch. Take a second. What are you grateful for? I was grateful for a moment of Mahalo, which Mahalo actually means thank you. So there you go. Besides that, you can book a reading with me. Email me, mimiclark@gmail.com for that. And the better it gets, the better it gets. There's more than enough love in the world for you, and you do have the power. Namaste.